Suddenly, it's 1975 again. Or at least Crosley would like you to think so, because this is their new 1975T stereo system. Featuring chrome and wood grain styling that was popular in the 1970s. Includes a built-in 2-speed 33 1/3 and 45 RPM turntable with an Audio-Technica AT3600L magnetic cartridge and adjustable pitch control. Also includes a built-in CD player, AM/FM radio tuner, auxiliary input, and Bluetooth. It includes this pair of bookshelf speakers with 4-inch drivers in them, which are ported on the back for better bass response. It has adjustable bass and treble controls, as well as a headphone jack. And when you turn it on, the display and tuning dial lights up in blue, currently in phono mode. You can switch between the different modes on this slide switch here. There's a CD player, aux input, AM/FM radio tuner, and the Bluetooth input. There you can switch the radio tuner between AM and FM. There's your CD player controls. And there's the drawer for loading the CD. And there's your volume control and tuning dial. On the back you have speaker and line output jacks, a DC 15 volt power input for the included external wall wart 15 volt 2 amp switching power supply. There you can see the information sticker. The official model number is CR6038A, WA for walnut finish. Unlike most of Crosley's other integrated stereo systems, one thing it does not include is a cassette player, not even one of those slot loading ones on the side, which is a little bit disappointing. But with the aux input and line output jacks, you could connect an external tape deck. Current price for this system, as of when I'm making this video in early December 2018, is $177 with free shipping on Amazon. The turntable includes a felt slip mat. It is a plastic platter underneath. The belt comes pre-installed. Includes the 45 RPM adapter, a little holder back there. And the whole thing is mounted on springs to help absorb vibrations. And when you first get it, you have to screw in this screw to release the tension on the spring and allow it to operate normally. The tone arm has a little clamp to hold it in place. Does not have a lifting lever, but you do get a finger grip on the back of here to allow you to cue up records manually. It is not auto return, but it is auto stop. So when it gets to the end of the record, it'll stop spinning and stay there in the middle until you pick it up. There's your switch for 33 1/3 or 45 RPM. Does not support 78 RPM. It looks like there should be a counterweight in here, but it actually uses a spring. And I measured the tracking force, and it's 3.5 grams, which is exactly the recommended tracking force for this Audio-Technica cartridge. The AT3600L cartridge comes with a stylus protector. It has a 0.6mm conical diamond stylus. Elliptical stylus upgrades are available to improve the sound quality. There's the pitch control I mentioned. It has a center detent position, but I found that it plays slightly too fast at both 33 1/3 and 45 RPM. I checked it with my strobe disc. So in order for it to play at exactly the correct speed, you should set it around here, and then it would play at the correct speed. One thing notably lacking from this system is any kind of USB functionality. So if you want to transfer records into your computer to make MP3 files, you will need either a computer with an analog line input or an external USB sound card. So let's give it a quick try. Later I'll give you a direct hookup through the line output. For now I'll be playing it through the speakers. That is with the bass and treble controls in the middle. Turn up the bass. I'll turn up the treble. Bass and treble controls don't have a particularly wide range, but they do give you some adjustability. I noticed there's no indicator on them to show you where they're actually set, although you can feel a notch in the middle, just like the pitch control. Again, that's with both of them in the middle position. I had it quite loud right there, and it sounded fine.
Network is a library of current music, additionally classified into slow, medium, and up-tempos. Listen.
So for the little bookshelf speakers it comes with, I think it sounds pretty good. Here's a sample of playing a 45. That song is called Stupid Rock by Slugbug, available on Bandcamp. Of course, it has no problems playing a record with the lid closed. And one neat trick is if you want to pause the record without having to open the lid and pick up the tone arm, just switch to another mode and it'll stop the turntable. And when you're ready to continue, just flip it back to phono. And I'll start playing again from where it left off. Here's my usual torture test record, Daft Punk's Homework album. And I'm pleased to report that this turntable does not have any problems with skipping when playing it. So unlike many inexpensive turntables, this one should not have any problem with skipping when playing bass heavy records. And here's a sample of how much range the pitch control has. Right now it's in the center position. That's all the way at the minimum position. And that's the maximum position. So it's not a huge amount of adjustability, but it's enough. Sounds like maybe one musical key plus or minus, give or take a little bit. And another thing I was pleasantly surprised to discover is that the turntable has anti-skating and it works perfectly. As you can see when I do the Laserdisc test, the tone arm does not skate into the middle unless I push it with my hand like I did there. So I'm very impressed overall with this turntable.
Sound great? Good. But we've got a great deal more.
Of course, this system has more than just a turntable, so let's try out the CD player. It's a fairly simple mechanism. You can see all the buttons right there. Nothing fancy like track programming or shuffle mode or anything like that. Just the basics. So you put in your CD there, and you can either push the button to close it or just push the tray and it'll close. And after a few seconds, it'll show the number of tracks on the CD, and it'll begin automatically playing from track one. Of course, you can skip tracks. And if you hold down the button, it'll seek fast forward or fast reverse. Play and pause. There's the fast reverse. And the display continuously alters between showing the track number and the elapsed time for that track. So there's no control over what it shows, it just keeps switching back and forth between the track and the time. And just like the turntable, the CD player sounds fine. Beginning of this track is a good test of the bass response. So not a whole lot of bass, but it's okay for 4-inch drivers and bookshelf speakers. About what you would expect from them. To test the aux input, here's my little iPod plugged into it. For copyright reasons, I can't play too much of each song, but you can get an idea of what it sounds like. Sounds fine. Here's a quick test of the Bluetooth functionality. It'll show up as Crosley CR6038. And here it is playing from the tablet through Bluetooth. I couldn't even see the floor. I'd be sad and blue. I can tell the audio quality is not as good as playing it from a CD, but that is to be expected because Bluetooth uses lossy compression, so it's like listening to an MP3 file. And finally, we have the radio tuner function. And even though this has an analog tuning dial, it actually uses a tuner that's based on a digital signal processor, or DSP. And I could tell right away when I saw it, because on DSP-based tuners, the AM tuning dial is completely linear, unlike most analog AM tuners, where the lower frequencies are spaced much farther apart than the higher frequencies. And digital signal processing based tuners are very common these days. I guess it's finally gotten to the point where using a digital chip is actually cheaper to manufacture than using old-fashioned analog components in the tuner. And it's certainly easier to assemble because they don't have to align a whole bunch of coils and trimmers. It's just all built into the chip. For picking up those local FM stations, it certainly does an adequate job. You have that common effect of DSP-based tuners where, as you tune across the dial, the sound gets choppy as it goes across the stations.
If you are a refugee already,
just give me more.
accepted are never charged or convicted.
More data.
Service priority.
Still staying out too late. So you can see it's picking up plenty of stations on FM. The FM antenna is this permanently attached wire, which isn't very long, but you could certainly strip off a little bit of insulation on the end and attach a longer piece of wire, or even possibly an outdoor antenna if you really want to improve the FM reception. Over on AM, it's really only adequate for the strongest local stations.
And he's got a fun personality, and I think he's...
Sounds like it has quite a bit of internal processor noise that it's picking up, because the AM antenna is actually built into the cabinet. So that's probably why it's picking up noise from its own internal circuitry. So AM performance is really not that great. Of course, the styling is going to be the main attraction of this system. And I think that's where Crosley has done a very good job of it. Of course, once you get up close, you're going to see the CD player and the Bluetooth symbol, and you'll know right away it's not from the 1970s. But from across the room, you certainly could be fooled that it is a vintage piece of equipment. Performance is not quite audiophile quality, but to be honest, a similar system from the 1970s would not be any better than this. Probably would have come with a BSR record changer with a ceramic cartridge and sapphire stylus, so just the fact alone that this has that Audio-Technica magnetic cartridge on the turntable makes it a significant improvement over that. And if you're a beginner to the world of playing vinyl records and you want something that's easy to use and affordable, but still has decent quality, this system certainly fulfills that goal, because the hardest part of setting it up was taking it out of the box. Everything else was very straightforward. So that's my review of the Crosley 1975T Retro 1970s style stereo system. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment if you have one. Oh,